The Jaime Dee Show. Live on KSKP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST, and live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jaime Dee Show, a real live morning radio show. What's up, everybody? Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's an absolute pleasure to have you all here today. I want to make sure if you guys can hear me, comment live in the chat right now. This is a real live morning radio show. And what you guys should know is that this is not a podcast. So when things happen, woo, things happen. Let me tell y'all. So I actually finally got my first ever fan texting service. And I was like, oh my gosh, I cannot wait to release it today. I was like, oh my God, I'm so excited to text all my friends. So excited for everybody to know that I'm live on air. We're starting on time. Mark Hayes did his job great. I pressed go live and my entire computer shut down. Y'all, the devil, look, I'm hot. The devil is working hard. I don't understand why dumb stuff like this happens, especially when I prepare. Let me tell y'all, I did my work so good last night. I made sure also to have everything set up. So for those who don't know, I was involved in an almost fatal car accident. So life has been life for me. And unfortunately, I don't have a car because the person who ran me off the road left. And when I came to, because I went unconscious for a bit, I realized I totaled my car. Shout out to Mark Hayes, who actually came, who was my general station manager and made sure I was okay. And shout out to my friend as well, Kennedy, who picked me up and made sure I was good. Y'all, it's just been a tough time. But I'm doing my show live from my house because naturally Radian said, where you at? Somebody flewed you out again. I wish. Y'all know I'm not going to cap. I hold myself accountable so you don't have to. I wish I got flewed out, but I'm doing it from my house. Oh my gosh, the devil is a lie. Tried to mess with me. I'm sitting here just like, I text all these new people too to check out my show, and this what happens? Mm-mm. But y'all know, I'm going to always keep it 100 with y'all so y'all know what's up. Just like Fab Five for Life podcast says, I'm here now. Yes, 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 and yes. All right, let's get into the show rundown. I'm going to go over some daily news. Do and have a conversation on when does flirting become creepy, and then can single moms raise sons on their own? Yes, can single moms raise sons on their own? We're going to have that conversation. I want you guys to stick around. You're always welcome to call in at 702-221-7283. Again, 702-221-7283. Or continue to comment live in the chat right now. I see LB, Ataji, Naturally Radiant, Andrea, Kara, LB, Elise. Yes, I see you guys. Mercy, Fab Five for Life. Yes, so happy to have you guys here. And Natural Aiden, thank you so much for your words. I was trying to keep that story short because I don't know what it is, man. Mentally, I'm still not okay. And trying to talk about that story makes me cry. I'm keeping it 100 with y'all. So I just try to tell y'all real quick so y'all can know what's going on. All right, let's get into this news. So I have driven from Vegas to LA and vice versa so many times since living on the West Coast. And I've always been confused and amazed by the random hotel and casinos placed in what I believe to be the middle of nowhere on the route to both locations. I always wondered why they decided to just build in those spots. It ain't like the drive between both cities is that far. It's like, yeah, let's stop and take an overnight break. It's only 4 hours between Vegas and LA, especially if there's traffic. But if you drive like we do out here, it's about like 3 hours and 30 minutes. Sometimes three. Now, the views do look cool though. I was also always super curious about the roller coaster that was attached to Buffalo Bills Hotel and Casino. I definitely always wanted to ride it because I love roller coasters. However, most of the hotels and casinos look closed to me. They look like ghost towns. But I was also never really going to stop my car to check it out either because, I mean, it is kind of still in the middle of nowhere and I am black. So I always forgot to do my research. So I just left my question of if the roller coaster hotel linger, if it's actually open linger, because it wasn't that important of a question for me to answer. Well, Park Pros on Instagram did a short story about them, and I finally got my question answered. Take a listen to what they had to say about the roller coaster and hotel and casino that is Buffalo Bills.
Tap into one of the most iconic roller coasters in the West. If you've ever driven to Vegas from California, then you've definitely passed the massive Desperado roller coaster at Buffalo Bill's Hotel and Casino in Prim, Nevada. This legendary 209-foot-tall hypercoaster opened in 1994 as the tallest roller coaster in the United States and second tallest in the entire world, and has become somewhat of a landmark for those traveling to Sin City. Buffalo Bill's and Desperado were temporarily closed in February 2020. And while the hotel and casino has since reopened, Desperado and the Adventure Canyon log flume remain closed. And while it has been seen testing occasionally, it's been almost 4 years since anyone has ridden Desperado, and it's unclear whether this iconic attraction will ever open again. At 5,843 feet long, Desperado was the ninth longest roller coaster in the world, wrapping in, out, and around of the entire Buffalo Bills Resort. Did you have the chance to ride this legendary roller coaster? Follow for more roller coaster content.
So the roller coaster is still not working, but the hotel and casino that is Buffalo Bills is open. I'm glad I know that information. Do I think that I will ever really stop there? Probably not. I mean, you know what? Maybe one day I'll stop just to be nosy, to look inside of the venue, but to actually stay there, probably not. I mean, it really isn't that far from Vegas. And to me, I don't know how y'all feel. When I be on road trips, I be wanting to get there. Like, we can stop to go pee, because I ain't gonna lie, my parents definitely traumatized me with that. They, oh my gosh, especially my daddy, he never wanted to stop the car. He gonna try to get on me for saying this. That man never wanted to stop the car. He always got an attitude. He did eventually do it, but that man traumatized me. So personally, I'm just like, I make sure if anybody has to go to the bathroom, we gonna stop to go to the bathroom. But if it's not pressing, we gonna press on, okay? I be trying to get to and from, not to in the middle and from. I'm trying to get out of this car and stay out of this car, okay? Hey guys, that is the first segment. We're gonna take a quick break, and when we come back, we're gonna go over some more daily news. I don't want you guys to go anywhere, because we are gonna talk about, when does someone's flirting become creepy, and can single moms raise sons on their own? Stick around. This is the Jaime Dee Show. And for those who actually got my text today, let me know in the chat down below. I'll be right back. Stick around.
Hello everyone, it's Shai from Nursey Cosmetics and Aesthetics Wellness Spa. We're located right here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Address 8360 West Sahara Avenue, Suite 220. We're located in the Summerlin area. Be sure to check us out. We are running specials on all services. That's right, 10% off all services the month of October, whatever you choose, regardless if it's a facial injectable treatment, body injectable treatment, wellness service such as IV hydration, weight loss therapy, or even skincare and getting a facial. We get 10% off all services this month. Be sure to mention the Jaime Dee Show and get an additional 15% off your next facial service. Make sure to give us a call at 725-205-1147. We hope to hear from everyone soon. And don't forget, our special deals in 10/31/23.
Doja Cat presents the Scarlet Tour 2023. Doja Cat live in concert in Las Vegas. With special guest Doshi performing at T-Mobile Arena Friday, November 3rd. Get tickets now at AXS.com. For more, visit DojaCat.com.
The Showroom at South Point presents Priscilla Presley.
It's my way to be able to keep Elvis's legacy alive, and hope you will join me.
View never-before-seen videos of the king. Hear personal inside stories about the man who was one of the greatest entertainers of our time. Tickets at the South Point box office. Online at southpointcasino.com or charge by phone. 702-797-8055. A personal evening with Priscilla Presley. November 3rd to the 5th.
So I hope to see you there.
At the South Point.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Jaime Dee Show. Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST and live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at the Jaime Dee Show. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I see we have Gina Chandler, Kara L, Fab Five for Life Podcast, Andrea. Yes, welcome, welcome, welcome. Hey, if you guys are listening in and watching the YouTube right now, you are more than welcome to actually sign in so that you're able to comment live. I will acknowledge your comments. So make sure to sign in using your Gmail account. Sign in on the YouTube, use your Gmail account, and actually comment live with me so I can acknowledge what you have to say, all right? And as always, you're more than welcome to call in at 702-221-7283. Yes, yes, yes. All right, let's get into more daily news. As written by It's On Site, a woman from Florida was arrested after reportedly assaulting her mother and stealing her car during an argument, reports WEH2. The incident occurred in Cocoa, Florida. Amber Shuren Runsack, 25 years old, reportedly had a heated verbal disagreement with her mother, during which she physically attacked her. After the altercation, Amber is accused of taking her mother's car and hitting her with it.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to laugh.
What is wrong with people? Oh my God, you ran over your own mom? That's not funny. I'm like shocked. A witness called 911 to report the incident, and police arrived at the scene to find Amber's mom injured. She was transported to the hospital in critical condition. However, reports added that she's stable. The exact cause of their argument is unknown. After leaving the scene, Amber abandoned her mother's car. She left the mama's car. God. However, Brevard County Sheriff's Office officers, aided by a canine unit, were able to locate her as she tried to hide nearby. And the dummy tried to hide. She was taken into custody and charged with aggravated battery and carjacking. The Cocoa Police Department mentioned that further charges may be added as the investigation progresses. This arrest makes Amber's 10th since 2018 and her fourth this year. Her previous charges include domestic battery, drug possession, prostitution, and battery. I'm sorry. I can't help but laugh. If you guys did not see this post on social media, the Instagram page is It's On Site. And she looks exactly how this story sounds. If that makes sense, she looks like a crackhead. On top of that, not even crackhead, heroin. And on top of that, my biggest issue is this makes her 10th time being arrested. Fourth time this year. Let that have been a black person. I'm sorry. Y'all know I don't try to make things race things, but let that be have been a black person 10 times, fourth time this year, and the girl had the audacity to run over her own mama. I just don't get it. On top of that, why is it that if we have repeat offenders out here doing things that they should not be doing and continuously being arrested, they are continuously being let out? I don't know how y'all feel, but I believe if there's repeat offenders out there who are not doing a justice to our communities, they should stay in jail. Tell me what you guys think. I mean, personally, yes, people do deserve grace. They do. It took me a lot to get that out because I was thinking about her situation. But no, I do believe people deserve grace. However, when it comes to stuff like this, when you are literally a threat to society and it's known that you're going to do dumb stuff and you look the way you look like a crackhead, I mean, I don't know what y'all want me to say. I believe the girl needs to stay in jail. But hey, it is what it is. Glad her mom's alive. Yeah. So the Neighborhood Talk reported that a Florida man who shot and killed a 21-year-old man for stealing merchandise in a GameStop store is now expressing his remorse, according to NBC South Florida. Derek Guerrero, 33, was arrested on a manslaughter charge after the incident occurred in the GameStop. Occurred. Wow, I don't know why my mouth could not say occurred. I'm saying that so weird. Occurred. There we go. Boom. Look, I hold myself accountable so y'all don't got to. He was working in the store when he noticed a man shoplifting. Derek attempted to apprehend the customer who taken off for the exit in an effort to escape. The assistant manager fired a single shot at the man, hitting his torso. The victim, identified as Chadwick Coates, later died of his injuries at the hospital. He was a sophomore at Florida Memorial University, also known as FLOMO, and was described as, quote, a good kid, end quote. Quote, at no time did the victim threaten Guerrero or display any type of weapon, end quote. Broward County Police said in a news release, the suspect had been released on bond just a day after the fatal shooting and expressed his regret for the incident. Quote, I'm really sorry for the family, end quote, he told the outlet. Quote, I didn't mean for any of this to happen to the family. It wasn't my intention, end quote. Take a listen to what NBC South Florida had to report. We're getting that up right now.
I'm really sorry for the family. I didn't mean for any of this to happen to the family. It wasn't my intention.
An apology coming straight from the GameStop employee accused of shooting a suspected shoplifter. Derek Guerrero making the remarks after being released from jail.
NBC6's Amanda Placencia was there for it all, spoke with him. You're live for us in Pembroke Pines. What else did he tell you, if at all?
Well, that GameStop employee, we know he bonded out of jail today, and now we're hearing from him for the first time.
Derek Guerrero was quiet as he left the Broward County Jail on Thursday, but expressed his remorse to the victim's family.
I'm really sorry for the family. I didn't mean for any of this to happen to the family. It wasn't my intention.
Pembroke Pines police say the 33-year-old GameStop employee was arrested for shooting and killing a man who was shoplifting inside the store on Pines Boulevard near Hiatus.
Upon the victim trying to leave the store with the merchandise, run out.
So my biggest issue is this. One, it's a Pokemon card.
I'm really sorry for the fact.
It's a Pokemon card. I totally get that this African-American boy should have not been stealing. I get it. I give you all that. I know there's going to be people out there who are like, don't disregard the fact that he stole. But that does not mean shoot somebody. You're not getting paid enough to protect these products. These corporations, these companies, these businesses have insurance. And it was just a Pokemon card. It wasn't a smash and grab. It wasn't the biggest item in the store. It wasn't the most expensive item in the store. It was a Pokemon card. Again, not disregarding the fact that we need to do better as people, especially in my community. We need to stop stealing. We need to stop doing the smash and grabs. We need to stop being nuisances to our communities. We need to stop doing things that aren't conducive to a healthy lifestyle. But to be killed because of a Pokemon card is outrageous. To me personally, I can only say this for myself. That guy needed a reason to shoot a black person, period. Because why? Why did you feel a need to shoot a innocent? Well, he's not innocent because he did steal. But why did you feel the need to shoot a unarmed black boy? Why did you feel the need to shoot a non-threat? And also, if this kid was exiting and not charging to you, why did you decide to shoot him? There's so many other things that could be done. But when I see things like this happen to my people, it hurts me. Because would you have done this if it was a young Hispanic boy? Would you have done this if this was a young white boy? What went through your mind to say, let me shoot this kid? Absolutely insane. Absolutely insane. May this kid rest in peace. May the family who and friends and those who are around who have been affected by this death find peace, clarity, and justice, because that he did not deserve to lose his life over a dumb Pokemon card. If you guys agree with me, let me know in the comments. If you don't, call in at 702-221-7283. But I always say this, the wrong people in our society have guns, period. So y'all, this video has been ranking rounds on social media, and it has me in shambles. A news reporter for CP24, which is a Canadian English language specialty news channel owned by Bell Media, decided to ask what seemed like two elementary black students what they told what they told her before she went live on air. Again, she asked these two young elementary black boys, hey, tell the world what you told me before I went live on air. Let me tell y'all, I was not expecting to hear what they had to say. Please take a listen to this video.
Great time. I had to pull this one aside. Hi, what's your name?
Giovanni.
Okay, Giovanni, tell everybody at home what you just said to me.
I told her that she looks better on a CP24 than in person.
Really? I love the honesty. No offense taken. You're so adorable. Thank you so much.
That's true.
Is that true?
No.
No. Oh, you think I look better in person?
No.
Okay, there you go. Thank you, guys.
So, y'all, I really was not prepared for this newscast. On top of that, I really want to know what made this lady decide to ask these two young black kids to say this. I get it makes funny content. I get it. But one, that's embarrassing. She took it so well. She took it so well. But like you really put that out there yourself. It wasn't like she was live on air and these kids stopped her to say it. She literally asked them to repeat what was said live on air. I don't know. That's embarrassing. That would have hurt my little feelings. I've been told I look better in person. I'll take that. Like, my pictures don't do me justice. Okay. But to tell me I look better on TV, dang. Okay. Now, I want to read y'all some comments before we go to break. Because, again, I feel like it's her fault for putting this on national TV. Nobody told her to embarrass herself, but also to exploit those little bad little kids. But people are actually going in on the kids on social media saying, I'm sorry, but this isn't cute. Y'all need to raise y'all kids better. And I would have told his little butt, you ain't too cute yourself. You look slow and your hair is uneven. Somebody said I would have quit my job and sued him for emotional distress. Kids are mean. But he'll say this is really mean. And I know that hurt her feelings. I really hope his mom or dad said something to him when he got home, child or not, that was mean and rude. Somebody else said, I had a student tell me that I was built like a tater tot. I can't. Y'all, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to have a conversation on when does someone's flirting become creepy. Shout out to my friend Sadora live in Miami, Florida, for texting me personally and just now saying, I like the shirt that you're wearing. Thank you, friend. I tried to look cute today. I did. I tried. All right, y'all, we're going to take a quick break. Don't go nowhere. And if any of y'all try to tell me I look better on my YouTube or any of my live streams or TV, we going to box. This is the Jaime Dee Show. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Hello everyone, it's Shai from Nursing Cosmetics and Aesthetics Wellness Spa. We're located right here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Address 8360 West Sahara Avenue, Suite 220. We're located in the Summerlin area. Be sure to check us out. We are running specials on all services. That's right, 10% off all services the month of October. Whatever you choose, regardless if it's a facial injectable treatment, body injectable treatment, wellness service such as IV hydration, weight loss therapy, or even skincare and getting a facial, you get 10% off all services this month. Be sure to mention the Jaime Dee Show and get an additional 15% off your next facial service. Make sure to give us a call at 725-205-1147. We hope to hear from everyone soon. And don't forget our special deals in 10/31/23.
Doja Cat presents the Scarlet Tour 2023. Doja Cat, live in concert in Las Vegas. With special guest, Doshi, performing at T-Mobile Arena, Friday, November 3rd. Get tickets now at AXS.com. For more, visit DojaCat.com.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Jaime Dee Show. Woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST, and live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at the Jaime Dee Show, and also now live on Instagram. Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is a real live morning radio show. Okay, real quick, before I get into this topic, when does flirting become creepy? I just want to say this. Y'all, I have a Doja Cat commercial on my live morning radio show. Pause. I don't know if y'all know this. I absolutely love Doja Cat. Doja Cat is my absolute favorite artist. I don't care what none of y'all got to say about what she does on social media. She be trolling y'all and y'all be falling for it. But the fact that I have a Doja Cat commercial playing in between my live morning radio show doing the commercials is so cool. I love that. Also, she's coming to Las Vegas this Friday. And shout out to my wonderful, I mean, absolutely wonderful general station manager, Mark Hayes, for hooking me up with some tickets. I'm going to see Doja Cat this Friday. This is honestly one of the best things that I could look forward to, especially after this car crash, because y'all, I've been going through it. Now, let me tell y'all this. Doja Cat, we over here playing your commercials. I better be called on stage when I go to your concert. I don't care how bad my back hurt. I'm going to give y'all a little eight count, and we're going to call it a day, okay? All right, let's get into this topic. When does flirting become creepy? I want to know. I really, really want to know. When does flirting become creepy? Also, shout out to William's family. Shout out to Andrea. Shout out to Gina Chandler. Shout out to Elise. Shout out to Kara. Shout out to everybody who's live right now. I see you guys. This real live morning radio show couldn't be what it is if it wasn't for you. All right, let's get into it. Y'all, I've had so many different kinds of people flirt with me. Men, women, underage people who thought they'd have a chance with me but were sadly mistaken. Let me say that again. Sadly mistaken, because I know a lot of y'all like to date underage people. We talked about that yesterday on my live morning radio show. Some of y'all are sick. Celebrities. Now, you know, I get flirted on by celebrities. I'm like, oh, I'm making it. Those with game, those without game, and more. Now, sometimes flirting can be fun. Sometimes be too much. And sometimes it really can be the wrong place and the wrong time. I'm single. So I personally enjoy a good flirting session, especially when a person is cute, knows they're doing, has good game. Let me know if y'all agree in the chat down below, whether it's on Instagram, I see y'all coming in, or whether it's on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook. Let me know. Or call in at 702-221-7283. You're more than welcome to get in on this conversation. Now, if I had a bae, I would be completely content, because I am really not a fan of flirting with many people, especially in the same setting. And I know a lot of people think us Geminis are flirts, and while that's true in certain situation, this Gemini is really content with one person. This one, let me make sure that's known, because I don't know why y'all think Geminis are HOEs out here, but this Gemini is good with one person. Now, again though, I'm single. So if I got a few drinks in me, that story might change. I mean, it is what it is. At least I'm honest. I hold myself accountable so y'all don't got to, okay? Now, I know a lot of people get a rise out of being flirted with, even if it's by an undesired person, because it makes them feel good. It boosts their ego and it shows them that they still have it. I get it. Now, right on for those people. But for me, on the other hand, if I'm flirted with by somebody I'm not interested in, I am immediately uncomfortable. I don't know how y'all feel, but if the wrong person is flirting with me, I am uncomfortable. While I'm a huge fan of being approached and hit on, if it's by the wrong person, I definitely do my best to let the person down respectfully, but I'm still uncomfortable. And I know it takes a lot of guts to approach somebody, and that person needs to be rewarded in some way for the efforts. That's just how I believe. Hey, I see you right there. Hey, Liliana. But no, for real, I personally believe that if somebody has the guts to approach you, you should be somewhat respectful and reward them for their approach, because it takes a lot for somebody to do that. It does. It does. There are so many people who don't want to be the approacher, or people like, I'm trying to say this the correct way. There are people out there who don't want to be an approacher, and people who don't like to be called the chaser and do the chasing, because there's a lot of people who just don't have the courage to. There's a lot of people who are traumatized. There's a lot of people who feel as though that they're going to get told no, so they'd rather not do it. And so if you have the courage to come approach me, I have sympathy for you, even if I don't want you. Now, however, there are people out there who take flirting way too far. They don't get the hint, and they can't take no for an answer. I know a few of y'all have been through that. Listen, a snapshot says, I'm a Gemini, and yes, I flirt. Listen, It is what it is. But no, seriously, if they take it too far and can't take no for an answer, that does not deserve any type of reward, any type of acknowledgement or anything, because to me, that is when your flirting becomes creepy and predatory. Now, this conversation came up because this Caucasian girl took to social media to show how this guy did the absolute most with his flirting and didn't take no for an answer while she was at work. Now, let's take a listen to this video and then discuss when does flirting become creepy. And if you have any crazy or horrible flirting stories like this girl does, let's talk about it. You're more than welcome to call in at 702-221-7283. Again, that's 702-221-7283. Or continue to comment on the live streams. I will acknowledge your comments. All right? Take a listen.
What? No.
Graduated?
Yeah.
So you're in college?
Mm-hmm.
Where at?
Kent.
That's your
house. Yeah, it's about 40 minutes.
How old are you?
19. I think you got it. Yep.
What city is Kent in?
Kent?
There's a city called Kent and the college is called Kent.
Mm-hmm.
Is that like East Cleveland?
No, it's Kent, Ohio.
So it's not even part of Cleveland?
No.
It's part of Northeast Ohio?
I guess.
I'm gonna take this.
Okay.
My friend.
321.
That thing with this and your oh shit, it's on me now. Is both his mine?
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, yeah. You wanna know my thing?
I'm good. Do you want your receipt?
Okay.
Alright, you're all set.
Am I
No.
Are you sure about that? You have Instagram?
No.
You're too cool for Instagram?
I don't like social media.
Why not?
Perpetuate some bad vibes from people.
You're cute.
Thanks.
Is that you said?
No.
You ever go to the beach?
Not really.
Lake Erie?
No.
On a boat?
It's not really a beach, is it? It's a lake.
Right now, because y'all heard this girl pretty much say no in her answers back to back to back. It was so obvious she was not interested. It was so obvious she was uncomfortable. Her body language said it all. Her answer said it all. And even though she was at work and trying her best to be respectful, he would not stop. Now, somebody on Instagram said, Snapshots said, flirting on the job is taboo. I'm going to say this. You can flirt with me on the job as long as you keep it cute, you keep it simple, and if I'm reciprocating, you understand that. If you don't understand that I don't want this and you keep going, now we're going to have a problem because you're doing too much. And remember, I am still at work. My biggest issue is why didn't this man just leave? Even Andrea says she's telling him no in her answers. Literally, she doesn't have an Instagram. She doesn't want to go to the beach. He asked her if she was too good for the beach. And a lot of times, she's lucky that this wasn't a super aggressive man, because when men get, not can't say speak for all men, but from other men out there, there are men out there who, when they get denied, they get aggressive. They start calling girls all types of B words and H words, and things get really messy. For me, that Rachel says, it gets creepy when they start looking at you like a piece of meat or keep going on when it's known I'm in a relationship. I understand. And I also understand that if you're not taking the hint, you are a creep. That man sounded creepy to me. He asked her if she was in high school. So it's like, if you saw a girl that was believed to be in high school, why are you flirting with her? I'm sure this guy was way older than college, because then he asked her if she was in college. So these questions aren't coming off as, let me do my justice, my research and make sure I'm not being a predator. His tone was very predatory, very creepy, very weird. And just like Tracy, the Way Up CEO says, her tone was giving uninterested vibes. Yo, take the hint. When you go out of your way to continue to pursue somebody who does not want you, that is when your flirting becomes creepy. I said what I said. I meant what I said. If y'all disagree with me, you can always call in at 702-221-7283 or continue to comment live on the Instagram or YouTube or any of the other live streams I'm on, because this is a real live morning radio show and I want you guys to get your opinions heard, okay? All right, so I read all the comments so far. We're going to move on to the next topic, and I want you guys to really get in on this. Can single moms raise sons on their own? When I tell you this topic is about to get real, I want y'all to stick around. This is the Jaime Dee Show. Remember, this is a safe space. We can agree, we can disagree, we can talk, we can not talk, whatever y'all want to do. But we're going to talk about these topics and do things that other shows aren't doing. Because remember, this is a real live morning radio show. So let's have this discussion. Can single moms raise sons on their own? Stick around. I'll be right back. This is the Jaime Dee Show. Don't go nowhere.
Hello everyone, it's Shai from Nursing Cosmetics and Aesthetics Wellness Spa. We're located right here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Address 8360 West Sahara Avenue, Suite 220. We're located in the Summerlin area. Be sure to check us out. We are running specials on all services. That's right, 10% off all services the month of October. Whatever you choose, regardless if it's a facial injectable treatment, body injectable treatment, wellness service such as IV hydration, weight loss therapy, or even skincare and getting a facial, you get 10% off all services this month. Be sure to mention the Jaime Dee Show and get an additional 15% off your next facial service. Make sure to give us a call at 725-205-1147. We hope to hear from everyone soon, and don't forget our special deals in 10/31/23.
Doja Cat presents the Scarlet Tour 2023. Doja Cat live in concert in Las Vegas. With special guest Doshi performing at T-Mobile Arena Friday, November 3rd. Get tickets now at AXS.com. For more, visit DojaCat.com.
The showroom at South Point presents Priscilla Presley.
It's my way to be able to keep Elvis's legacy alive and hope you will join me.
View never-before-seen videos of the king. Hear personal inside stories about the man who was one of the greatest entertainers of our time. Tickets at the South Point box office. Online at southpointcasino.com or charge by phone 702-797-8055. A personal evening with Priscilla Presley, November 3rd to the 5th.
So I hope to see you there.
At the South Point.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to The Jaime Dee Show. Woo! Live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST, and live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jaime Dee Show, a real live morning radio show. For those who are live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook, I appreciate you guys so much. For those who are live in their cars right now, thank you all so much for not turning that radio dial. And for those who are coming in right now on the Instagram, I really, really appreciate you. If you're just now tuning in, I went over some daily news. We had a conversation on when does someone's flirting become creepy? And now we're going to have a conversation on can single moms raise sons on their own? People are already coming in. They're already commenting. Chris says, why wouldn't we be? Christina says, why wouldn't we be able to? Don't understand why that is a question. I'm going to explain to you why that's a question in just a bit. Stick around. I'm telling y'all, this is a real live morning radio show. We get into some things on this show. Make sure y'all subscribe on the YouTube to make sure you know when I'm live on air, all right? Because if you're not in Las Vegas and aren't in your cars, you can always watch me live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, or Facebook at The Jaime Dee Show. All right, now let's get into this. In a podcast interview, Charleston White, known for sharing stories of his criminal past on social media, feuding with Soulja Boy, becoming a motivational speaker, commenting on rap culture and more, says single moms can't raise sons on their own. That's why that conversation came up. It's going very viral on social media and the people are going at it. He said, quote, a mother's love is not efficient enough for a boy. He has to have some type of male love and it has to be consistent to balance out the consistency of a mother's love. That's end quote. Now, this is a very touchy subject because I agree and disagree with this topic in a few ways. And what he has to say, not really agreeing with everything, right? So I personally believe the wrong woman who is not ready to have kids and is forced into or decides to go into single motherhood cannot raise a son. Same for a single father. Hey, if you want to fight me, let me know at 702-221-7283 or comment live on the Instagram because Miss Mac says everyone needs a village. Now, hear me out. Yes, I understand that having a male figure in a young boy's life is needed and what a lot of young boys need. I do agree with that and I do understand that. But the wrong male figure can also mess up a young boy's life as well. Don't sit here and act like men just being present is just going to fix what young boys have going on. I think when approaching the subject, we forget that because of social construction of reality, the spaces Black people have been forced to live in, aka the hood, the drugs that the government has pumped into the Black neighborhoods. If you want to fight me, you can go ahead and fight me. There's been several documentaries that have told the truth about how the government has pumped cocaine, heroin, and all these other drugs into Black communities, how they bombed Black communities, how they've arrested Black men on purpose, how they separated Black families on purpose. Fight your mama, not me, because this is literally stuff that has actually happened and has been proven. And this is why we need to stop trying to get rid of history books. Just saying. Now, people also forget how the police have kept young Black families apart and how the media represents Black people and how that plays a huge part in why our Black communities and people are so messed up. I said what I said. I meant what I said. If you don't agree with me, you can always call in at 702-221-7283 and you're more than welcome to comment live. Tracy says, boys/men these days could be categorized as more sensitive and unable to take rejection as well as back in the day, and mental health issues are rampant. It could be a dangerous line to walk. And yes, single mothers can raise sons into men. With the right knowledge and insight into a real manhood, it's doable. Could be helpful to also keep positive male mentorship around and available. I agree. LB says, I don't know why moms are always targeted. Where are these men that claim they could do such a good job? Step up, men. They're not wrong. Listen, we as a Black community are so broken and lost. It is literally sad. We have generations who never get to break curses because of the families and environments they're born in. We have families who never receive the resources and education they need to escape their environments. We have people who know better and who just don't apply themselves. And we have people who literally just don't know better. That is really a thing. On top of that, we have Black women who are living every day in a state of hurt and shock. I said what I said. We have Black women who are living every day in a state of hurt and shock. Not only because they have to deal with the pressures of the world, the pressures of their female anatomy. Let's not forget, they literally have a different biological makeup than men do, and the pressures to heal back families, but also because Black men are treating Black women like they are literal trash. I said what I said. Look at all these podcasts. Look at all these dumb conversations we're having on social media. Look at what happens in the world now. Trust me, I know because I've lived in both the hood and the suburbs of Chicago, and I've seen how men treat women. I've seen how Black people treat other Black people, and I've been a part of a group of men who have stood up for other Black women who were victim of a Black man's rage, mistreating, and abuse. So when I see all these Black men get on podcasts and drag Black women who do their best, who are known to be some of the biggest pillars and rescuers in our communities, and who quite frankly make more money than most Black men, it saddens me. Period. Women are just as much at fault as raising bad kids as men are. It is not solely just women's fault. And for the men who only fault women as the problem, you all are just a part of the problem as women are. Now, we have so many men who jump to bash Black women, especially a single Black mom, but aren't even raising their own kids. Wrapping it up to prevent more fatherless kids. You heard me right. We have men out there who are not wrapping it up to prevent more fatherless kids. Y'all out here shooting up the club everywhere you go and more. Shoot, it's usually the Black men who do Black women dirty and who wouldn't even marry a Black woman who do the most talking. And to me, that's sickening. I just don't understand why Black people hate on other Black people so much. Like, it really sucks when you come to the realization that it literally be your own people. Trust me, I have been a victim of Black hate against people in my own community, even while living in Vegas. The way other Black people treat other Black people, especially other men treat other Black men in Vegas, is disgusting. Like, it is the crappiest feeling ever. And the fact that this happens so often literally pisses me off. Well, I want us all to take a listen to what Charleston White had to say, because we're out of time. And I want us to discuss, can single moms raise sons on their own or no? I'll let you know, there are a few curse words at the end. So this is a warning if you don't want to hear that. It's a part of the story, which is why I kept it in the show. So please take a listen and let's discuss if single moms can raise children, young boys, on their own. Take a listen.
Mother's love is not sufficient enough for a boy. People think, mother's love is not sufficient. He have to have some type of male love, and it has to be consistent to even balance out the consistency of a mother's love. Without that balance, mothers ruin boys. You love on them too long, you ruin them. At some point, he has to go through some training or some discipline, some hard teachings. Man, I ain't never been spanked by a man. I ain't never had a hug from a man. I ain't never heard a man say, I'm proud of you. It was all mama. Even though our uncles was around, mm-hmm. They street guys. They teaching you the bullshit. And they young. I ain't never seen a man come out my mother's bedroom, but she had a boyfriend.
Yeah.
So that aspect of just growing up, with that missing piece of a male figure in your life, naturally, you seek out to fill that void away from your mother's home. Mm-hmm. The things that your mother tell you to do don't make sense amongst boys. When she fixing your coat as a little bitty boy and she giving you instructions on what to do to get back home, you don't. When you become an adolescent and the things that your mother say to you, if you go out there and do that with other boys, you go get treated like a punk. Hmm. And if your mother try to make you tough enough to go out there and deal with the boys, she might create a killer. Hmm. So you can only show them how to be a good woman. Man, we had a homeboy. He used to sit down and pee. He never seen a man stand up and pee. Because your mother teach you to sit down and pee. That psychologically does something to a boy. Mm-hmm. Boys aren't supposed to sit down and pee. Well, what do mama do? She gets you a pot and she trained you to sit down to pee. Mm. When do you learn to stand up? When? It's a whole lot of little boys sitting down peeing. When do you learn to stand up? Because all behavior is taught. All behavior is learned. Okay, well, where do you learn to sit down? Watching mama. Why you think little boy, mama's supposed to close the door when he try to come watch her pee? Most women let her infant boy come in the room, watch her pee, right, watch her get dressed, and he take on those traits and characteristics from here. Mm-hmm. You can put that same baby with a wolf, and he'll behave like a wolf. So you figure by the time this kid get 9, 10 years old, he never sees a man stand up and pee. What do we learn? Prison is the tool God uses to strengthen and make all of us better men. Our mothers can't do it. She tried. That's why we all have to go to prison. That's why most of us who leave our single mother home have to go to prison and go meet some kind of man in prison. Say, nah, look out, little homie. Let me show you how to throw your right hand. Nah, look out. Let me show you how to block that punch. He didn't know that before he got to prison. All the things that our mother tell us to do does not help us to be better men. Mm. As a matter of fact, the things that our mothers try to raise us to be, she's raising us to be the kind of men she wouldn't even date. Mama, can I get your car keys? She'll give us her car keys all the way up until she's 30. But the man she dates, she won't. But she'll give it to her. And the man she dating, sit up and say, boy, you let that boy do every goddamn thing. He can get your money. He lied to you. I lied to you goddamn. I'm fucking you. Is he fucking you? You and your boy fucking? Motherfucker start.
So we run out of time, y'all. So I'm about to cut in.
He be a weak motherfucker.
So Charleston White said a lot of things. He said a lot of things. There are certain things I agree with, like the wrong person who's not ready to be a mother cannot raise a son. But there are a lot of efficient black women out there who do an amazing job at raising their sons. Take a look at the comments under those videos that are being released, the Charleston White's interview. There are a lot of women out there saying they did a good job, their sons do this, all these different things. But I also agree that when young boys see the wrong examples of how to grow up as a man, that will deter their minds, that will mess up how they're raised, and that won't raise an efficient young boy. I get it. But what Charleston White is talking about, let's be very honest, he's talking about a hood-ass mama. He's talking about a black mama in the hood who don't got the resources, who ain't moving right, who ain't living right, who ain't even really there in their son's life right and more. And that's sad. It sucks. But he can't speak for all black moms out there. There are a lot of single black moms out there who are doing a great job as single parents, and I want to give them their flowers. Black women rock, period. Protect black women, period. I said what I said. We can go on more and more. But hey, this is the end of the Jaime Dee Show, live on KSHP AM 1400 and 107.1 FM every Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. until 11 a.m. PST. If you want to promote your business, hit me up at info@jaimeedee.com. Love you guys so much. Have a good day, and I'll see you tomorrow. What's up, everybody? You were just tuned into the Jaime Dee Show, live on KSHP AM 1400. And 107.1 FM. If you aren't in the Las Vegas area, you can catch my show live on YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook at The Jaime Dee Show. That's THEJAIMEDEESHOW. If you want to advertise your business on my show, email us at info@jaimeedee.com. Thank you all so much for your support. See you tomorrow.